Here's GLGD with that Aghanim's bite on Fade Beyond.
Let's see. Let's see if
I just checked in Feeble because they changed it. James Q. Yeah, he's super dead.
Yep. Shackles out. And they try and get the first bit over towards Nisha, but Zai will take it just to be safe. Zai, he's going to get gone on. Tries to step in very aggressively, and of course with the first point of the Shackle shot, he's not going to have any way to escape. Nice juicy brains for Puppy. Ready, 3v3 down on the bottom lane. As they'll turn towards Yapzor, Yapzor is going to get beaten down here. Now Matuma Man, he's got to be careful. He's falling low. Pierce GLG, they'll be able to run him down and finish him off. Another kill. As White does go down, but two kills for Pierce GLG. I mean... looking down towards bottom. Puppy, he's going to go for the setup onto Jinq. They've got the damage and control. Yapzor on the lead in. Jinq does have the boots, of course. Also a few stick charges, and Zai, he's getting taken down by Y.
Yeah, just KS this. Nice.
Easy, the classic Shaman move there from Jinq. That's another kill for PSG LGD down on this bottom half.
Fade Beyond plays them, whether it's a Beastmaster, whether it's a Nature's Prophet, like these are his most played heroes, I believe, in the Chinese Season 1. Rune, gonna spawn on bottom. It's regeneration, a big one. Let's see if Earth Spirit... Earth Spirit? Yeah, they might get a kill here.
He's got the Flame Guard. They've got the right clicks. I take him down. Jinq tries to grab Nisha. But Nisha, this is gonna be pretty much as fast as it gets.
Did you do the math, or did you pull that out of your ass?
I did the math, let's say.
You did the math?
We'll go okay. With that. As bottom lane, again, Puppy, believable.
You didn't convince me. Try it again.
Mid lane. Here we go. They've got the catch on to Puppy. This time backup's in. Yapzor and Nisha trying to turn things around. The stomp comes down. Jinq, he's got the stick charges. Into the trees he goes. Bane holding back. Nothing to say for now. With the Nightmare. But nothing to say. Still able to jump in. Over towards Nisha. Nisha cut down by the Slide of Fist. As they bring down the puck. White taking some tower hits. That will cause him to go down. Secret will find the two of them, but they lose. They certainly proved to be able to do that last game. So far, 9 minutes in, 5-6, 1k lead for PSG LGD. Fade Beyond, ready to come in with some aggression up top with the shapeshift popped. Nothing to say, he's in with the wraparound, sets up with the chains onto Yapzor, but TP's coming in. Return shackles and Nightmare, hold back, nothing to say. Dreamcore dropped down by Nisha. Have they got actually any damage to kill the leashed heroes though? They don't. Fade Beyond's able to wait out the Dream Coil and get back to safety.
It's Necrobook 2 already done. Like, they get nothing out of this shapeshift, but... oh, good shackle.
And turn, though, the chains around to Zai. Stomp as well. Locks down the Windranger. Jinq coming in from the side. He's going to have that extra burst to bring down Zai. Puppy as well. Getting beaten down by Y. Jackal's onto Nisha, but Yapzor's able to throw out the silence. Stop the channeling as Nisha can jump away with the orb. Two dead, though, on Secret. As this attempt to fight PSG LGD does not end great for them. And around these rune spawns as well, so PSG LGD should be able to get the majority of these.
And meanwhile, all this is happening, like, Ame just can potentially backfire. Like, Lycan with the Necrobook 3 has a dispel mechanic. He goes and you're just straight up dead.
See, set up for nothing to say. Now I'm going to be very, very
EKB to be able to stand your ground coil on 2.
See if they can finish off the kills. Actually, they're turning. Nothing to say. Jinq just going to hold their ground. Turn with the lockdown onto Yapzor. Yapzor, he's going to get the back of Matuma Man jumping in. The stomp's out. The sleep's going to catch the two of them. Yapzor goes down. They will lose Jinq. Fiend script for Puppy. Locks down the Ember Spirit. The follow Shackle Shot will connect as they bring down Nothing to Say. But why? He's just beating them all up. It's 4 dead on Secret.
Yeah, once Fade Beyond, almost a must pickup. Must have item, for sure.
Top lane, Jinq.
Jinq again.
He's just able to get the catch on Tanisha. Shackle will stop the shackle of the Shaman, so backup will allow Nisha to live. Jump and initiation and chase from Fade Beyond.
Secret will also have problems maintaining vision against Necro 3 bottom. Snap the coil, 4 people, pretty dead.
Tricks to get up to the high ground. They're getting the vision with the wolves, and that's going to set up for them to find the catch onto Puppy. Good moves here from Fade Beyond, and the summons across the map.
They can go and take the bottom tower just later.
It gave Fade Beyond just a completely, you know, perfect opening to the game. So over in the mid. Look for the catch on Tanisha. They've got him. A lot of catch between the two. You know, if nothing to say, or she
Just going in for a BKB, not going in for a BKB, going for his own KB. That's Monkey King Bar.
Now down bottom, Nisha is trying to get aggressive onto Nothing to Say, but Faith Bian, he's coming across with a shapeshift. Secret's got to run. As Faith Bian turns over towards Zai, Zai is able to get the whim run off in time. It's going to come to an end. The boundless strike comes crashing down from Arme. Zai get taken out. Another kill for Faith Bian as the rest of Secret have to scatter themselves across the map and get away from the chase of this Lycan. Q. He's on the hunt for Yapzor, and he's going to find him. The setup's there. I'm bringing Y over, see if Y can get in position for the stomp. He can. They've got enough damage between the two of them. They're bringing Nothing to Say over as well.
Another Hex is available.
Closing the gap with the remnants.
Yeah, just shaman things.
the amount of lockdown between the way things have started, but 2-6-3. Went for that bots first. He wanted to get the Maelstrom, but feels pressured to get the BKB done before he upgrades the Javelin to the Maelstrom. And it's all caused just a very slow progression with his items.
Yeah, just doesn't deal enough damage right now. They're going to go on him. Chain, we'll get the Windranger.
That just disappears. Disappears to the army of Faith Bian.
Still has a Yule Scepter. Oh, what a juke by Nisha, but is it?
He could still be dead here. He's got to drop the Dream Call in an attempt to run. The silence is on him. The Necro Books continue to beat him down. Will manage to jump away.
My monkey, is he chasing?
No, he's in a tougher position than they were in game one. And game one was tough. There's Nothing to Say. Finding the setup. On to Zai. Zai's going to go for the TP out, but Jin Q, he's ready with the Hex. Has another death. On Zai.
Shaman just completely popping off. They're going in.
Puppy. He's got to run. Him and Matu have got to get out of this as Arme.
Still 20 seconds on Aegis.
That will be out back long enough for them to escape. Top lane. He was trying to push it out, but Jin Q was ready. As the mid lane. And look to start taking away the base of Secret.
Like an ulti. He wants Bane.
And he'll get it. Puppy dead and gone. Roshan taken. She's recaused their life from PSG LGDina. They have got a good chance of taking a fight 3v5 because of how big they are. And in the mid, the jump's been made onto Matuma Man. Matuma Man just gets taken out before he can do anything at all. And now Secret, they've got to back off. They've got to run. Remnant down from Nothing to Say as he chases over towards Puppy. Puppy will also fall. As they may have had the number advantage. And obviously Secret feel they do.
I think that potentially their 4s and 5s have buyback. Matumba Man dies straight away. They don't have enough
Nisha.
Damage. Like, this is their damage. Nisha also does not have a defensive item. He's just straight up dead.
See if he can find any money. As he's looking for a kill. He's in onto White. White, he's going to have the backup. Jin Q just turns with a Hex. Yapzor will roll in, get the science down on the two of them. Match is able to put the BKB. They will once again be able to take down the two supports as they immediately TP out of there. Matu will manage to get back to base. And the rest of Secret, Zai, able to turn, cuts the tree with the power.
That Monkey King bar, it's just going to be so much easier dealing with the Windranger and, of course, Phantom Assassin, Boundless misses.
Well, Zai's got to run. As they're hunting, Jin Q, he's going to be able to reach in, set up with the Hex. As they've got the catch, they've got the kill. Another one for Arme.
Does not connect on anything.
Well, now they've got to be careful, Secret, because PSG LGD are going to come straight running at the Puppy. Turns, puts the sleep over onto the Elder Titan. Has nothing to stop Arme though, as Arme takes down the Bane. Nothing to say, and Faith Bian chasing Matu back towards the base. He's got to put the BKB to stand a chance of surviving. Will turn.
Picked up a double damage.
Serpent wards down. Secret not really any way of taking those out, as PSG LGD will get away with this. Boundless strike to open up onto Nisha. Arme just steps in with the Abyssal Blade. Nisha is cut down by the Slider Fist, out for 70. No buyback available on the puck.
Still feel they should try to take one more fight. Arme has cheese.
Oh! They're in with the catch. They've got the setup on a Puppy. Straight away they commit on also. They'll be able to find the lockdown onto Matuma Man. Matuma Man, he's got to run. Will manage to jump up.
Puppy's going
to
die again.
Boundless strike down on the two of them. They catches both Nisha and Puppy. An immediate dieback from Puppy on the Bane. And now the chase continues inside of the base. They get the Hex onto Matu. Shackle shot. Will hold back. Nothing to say in Faith Bian. But Arme's jumping in looking for Zai. Zai keeps his distance. Oh, the Absol just rolls straight in. Will set up for the power shot to get the kill. But they're calling it. It is absolutely done and over. A Secret called GG. PSG LGD take game 3. And with that, the series is theirs. 2-1 against Secret. With both of their victories. This one in particular.